Midnight Commander? Well, guys, how can you not use the Midnight Commander? Seriously, hey, this is the kind of application you install by default and never use. And right from there, it asks you if you want to install it right away or you want to try it. We want to try it, so we're gonna press this one, try elementary. Hey guys, and welcome to a new episode of Nomadic Dmitry channel. So in this video, we're gonna be trying different versions of Linux distros on a Mac. And to be specific, it's a MacBook Pro 2014. And I know this is not the latest Mac, but still, it's very suitable to running the Linux distros, and it runs those blazingly fast, so why not try this, right? So I also thought, why not try this? Because when it comes to running alternative operating systems on Mac, many people say that, well, Mac is just intended to run macOS, right? And just macOS and that's it. I totally disagree with this opinion, because it's totally fine to boot any Linux operating system on that, like why not? The only problem with running Linux on a Mac, on a MacBook Pro specifically, on any Apple laptops, battery life is not great on Macs when you run Linux on those. That's unfortunately the truth, and if you are concerned about battery life, you use your computer a lot on a battery, then you might consider just sticking with the macOS or Windows. In Windows, actually, the battery management is not that bad. But when it comes to running Linux distros, we have a lot of questions, like which specific Linux distro I need to run on the Mac, right? Which specific distro I should pick? Well, in that sense, I would divide those distros in multiple categories. To be specific, it will be four categories, in my opinion. So one category is intended to have a specific tool set. For example, the Kali Linux, right? Kali Linux is intended for penetration testing. Well, it's actually like, it has lots of network tools built in, and it's really good for that. And this is one of those categories. Next category is a beautiful distros like elementary. We're gonna be trying actually both Kali and elementary in this video, and you're gonna see for yourself. Then the next category is distros intended to run on very low specs machines. Well, as well as on the high-end spec machines, like why not? Those Linux distros don't have much graphical stuff, but at the same time, it does what it should do. It runs the internet applications, run the utilities, and you don't have any problems with that. It just runs. It's just not very beautiful, but it just runs, and it's totally fine. So if that's your intention, that's another point to consider. So antiX, I actually used antiX to rescue the boot of my SSD drive, which has Linux installation, so you can see the video. So antiX is one of the distros you can consider running on your Mac if you actually want to be like super fast, blazing the fast experience on your Mac, so why not? And then it's a general purpose category of Linux distros. And of course, it's either Ubuntu or Kubuntu, Xubuntu, or any other distro which is based on Ubuntu, basically. So this is like general purpose distros, and it's totally fine to run those as well. Like, why not? Well, guys, when it comes to running Linux on not just Mac, but any computer, it's all about what exactly you want, which tools you need. And for that reason, you can start with any distro you like. Just pick one that you especially like. And let's go ahead and actually check out all those distros that I have. So let's go. All right, so the first distro we're gonna try will be the Kali. As I said, this one is used for system administrators and many people who are doing the penetration testing and stuff like that. So let's start this distro. And you can see that I have the refined boot menu I installed before. So I'm gonna select the Kali Live right here. And it's gonna load. And I'm gonna pick the first option, Live System. And it also has the option to actually install it on your hard drive, for example, Start Installer. But we just want to try it, right? So we just press the Live System. And let's see, it's gonna boot. Quite beautiful splash screen here. I like it. Alright, so it finished loading, and well, we can explore basically what it has. It has the terminal right here, and you can already use it. And yes, quite beautiful theme actually right here. And the main thing here is that it has a bunch of system administration tools. It has information gathering, vulnerability analysis, web application analysis, database assessment, password attacks, wireless attacks, exploitation tools. It has a bunch of those guys, and I think this is like really cool for educational purposes. It's really great. You can just learn a lot about network. After I finish with this video, I'm gonna explore Kali Linux more. LSPCI command, by the way, shows the devices that you have on your system. And the thing is that, guys, I have this Broadcom network adapter right here, but I still don't have any Wi-Fi, because even though it shows it here, it doesn't actually work. So I need to install a driver here. And that's the problem with using Macs on those distros, and it's at least the live version. This driver is proprietary and you need to install specific package to actually be able to install it. I'm gonna provide the command in the description. So if you want to have network connection, and probably you want to have it, I'm gonna provide it in the description down below. So please check it out. All you need to do is either download this package offline and just install it from the flash drive, or you're gonna just pull it from, let's say you stick this flash drive into another device, another computer, you install it, and then you just have it. You just have a Wi-Fi connection. Applications, and yeah, it's also when you right click, you also have a bunch of applications here. And let's see, I mean, that's a lot of tools right here. Wow. File manager. What is the default file manager? So this is the default file manager. And let's see, I saw the Wireshark here. Okay, I'm gonna type Wireshark. Yeah, Wireshark is the great utility for network packages analysis, and this is really great that I just included this one right here. I mean, once you have the internet connection, you can do a lot of useful, good stuff. I'm not saying anything about any destructive stuff, because guys, doing destructive stuff on the internet is not good. It's actually illegal, so don't do that. So this distro is great for learning information security, information technologies, and this is great. Let's shut it off and try another distro. Alright guys, the next distro we're gonna try is this one. I think this is antiX, so let's see if it's actually that one or not. I installed before, so it actually should work fine. All right, let's see. Okay, and yes, this is the one. And this boot menu you already saw from my previous video about rescuing your Linux installation on your Mac. Check it out if you haven't seen it, it's probably useful for you. But anyway, let's actually run this live CD, no, live thumb drive version, right? Because it used to be live CD and all that. I'm actually glad that we don't have any CDs anymore. CDs or DVDs, it's actually so good. All right, so here it is. I actually love the simplicity of this one. So as you can see, we have the statistics right here, and it says about memory usage, swap usage, stuff like that, and it's actually nice. And so super fast. I mean, okay, web browser, editor, what else? It's just like terminal. Anything you need, actually. What's actually in the default toolset? Games. Yeah, it has Dustbox integrated right here, which is cool. I love it about this distro. And yeah, you can actually start typing, start word processing right from there. What else it has? Oh, and multimedia. It has, well, surprisingly, it doesn't have VLC here. Wait, it's too fast. When I move my mouse, it just like goes away too fast. Firefox, ESR, and yeah, it has a bunch of different browser options, which is cool. Multimedia, programming, even programming tools, Gini installed right here. So you can open up right there. And yeah, I mean, guys, this is cool. But it has the same problem. Wi-Fi is not detected on many Mac computers. And as I said, the solution is the same. Just install the specific package and that's it. It's gonna work. Actually, most of the time when you install it on a hard drive, it actually installs this package, because this package is included in the extended version. It's like when it installs all the drivers, this package is included usually. So don't worry, just install it on a hard drive, and then if it doesn't work, you just use one command, boom, and it's working. So also very simple file manager as well. And the same thing. Well, I mean, it works super fast. And actually, let's go to terminal and htop. So let's see the memory usage. The memory usage right there is 325 megs out of the 16 gigs I have. So guys, it's just nothing. It just like runs blazingly fast on this machine. I mean, it's gonna just run like crazy. So I mean, great system. So we're gonna go and shut down this one and switch to another distro. Next one, let's see. Next one is elementary OS. Let's try this option, EFI first. Alright. The splash screen is really nice, I love it. I actually tried elementary OS a couple of years ago and I didn't use it extensively, I just tried it. I'm gonna tell you why. So it keeps booting, it takes time, and right from there it asks you if you want to install it right away or you want to try it. We want to try it, so we're gonna press this one, try elementary. And you can pick any language actually here, so which is cool. Cool option for those who don't speak English much or prefers other language. And as you can see right away, it's quite similar to what? It's quite similar to Mac. All this start, this whole program's menu looks similar to Mac. And this, guys, is the reason why I have not used it much. Because it looks too similar to Mac. It tries to emulate the Mac interface that you feel like, well, I installed Linux to be actually using Linux, not Mac. So why it's all trying to implement all that? Alright, but default web browser is Epiphany. And by the way, you see, once you launch it, this whole panel just goes away automatically. You just like launch it and that's it. And then what about this one? Calendar. The calendar is nice. I mean, nice set of apps included with this one. I like it. But at the same time, like, this simplicity is like kind of annoying, I would say, for some users like me. Yeah, I like it. This photos thing. I mean, I don't know. It depends on the user, of course. And it also has interesting app model. Basically, it has the like kind of app store, but you pay what you want. So basically, you pay, if you want the app to cost $5, you pay $5. If you want like $1, you just pay $1. Not sure about the free ones, if you can just specify zero. Because to download this elementary OS, I was asked how much I want to pay and I just specified zero. And I got it, so I guess the same goes with the apps, so you guys check it out. Installed, yeah, and it has all the installed stuff. Yeah, so this driver is actually the reason why the Wi-Fi doesn't work. As you can see, there is no Wi-Fi here. So if I press here to install it, install anyway, because it Linux doesn't like proprietary software, right? And this is the reason why they don't include it in the first place, this driver, bcmlwl-kernel-source. So I'm installing, I guess this one is included, so which is cool. It makes sense. I mean, in elementary OS, this driver is included, and once it installs, I'm gonna have the wireless network access here, so which is great, I think. You see, it has the Broadcom drivers, basically. This is exactly the one I need for my machine, Broadcom driver. And once it installs, it actually indicates by sound that there are Wi-Fi networks available, and you can just pick any Wi-Fi you want. So guys, this is how it's solved. Or you can just download it manually, and in any distro you want, you can just use this driver and the Wi-Fi network is gonna work, which is totally fine. I like the interface here, I like all this stuff, but as I said, it feels like too simple. Sometimes this simplicity is a bit too annoying, but if you guys actually prefer this super simple interface, and by the way, good selection of tools available here. For example, this gparted is included by default, you don't need to install anything. What else is here? Files, install elementary OS, screenshot, app, code. Okay, which ones? You can code from here, but what app is that actually? I'm not sure. So, is the name of the app code? Anyway, what else? What else? And terminal and videos. Watch videos and movies. Again, I don't even know the name of the app. Is it like some proprietary or something included with just elementary OS? I guess it's something just written for this OS. Not sure. So basically, this is how it works with elementary. If you like this simple interface, if you want your Linux distro just to work, and as you can see, the necessary drivers are already included, you can just drive it from live thumbnail drive and use it. So no problem. All right. So we're gonna shut this one down and try the last one. Try the last distro I have for you today. And guys, the last distro I have for you today is what? It's Kubuntu. It's the one I'm actually using primarily on my machine. This is the one I love the most, I guess. And guys, Kubuntu is a distro that is actually installed on my hard drive. It's not a live version, it's actually installed on my hard drive. Here's my Kubuntu installation. I just love the KDE interface. I mean, you can pick any desktop environment you like, but I especially like KDE. Here it is. I don't know, guys, it just like fits my needs. That's why I love it. Default applications here. Well, actually a bunch of them. There was a Firefox web browser by default, but I installed Chromium. Well, I don't know, I just got used to Chromium. And by the way, I have review of Brave web browser. If you want, you can install Brave and use it. Graphics, it has GIMP installed by default, Blender Commander, Ocular. Actually, Ocular, I love it. I love this PDF reader. I was actually wondering if it's available for a Mac or not. I'm gonna check it out anyway. Inkscape, Vector Graphics Editor. Well, lots of good apps here. Utilities, Midnight Commander. Well, guys, how can you not use the Midnight Commander? Seriously, hey, this is the kind of application you install by default and never use. In my opinion, I mean, I just installed and never use it. Because, I mean, I just love it, but I never understood, like, why I would actually need it. Okay, the system monitor is good. You can see the CPU memory usage. And as you can see, it's like it's not using any memory compared to Mac OS. It's just like a 400 megs of memory out of 16. It's just nothing. It just flies here. It just runs fine from external drive. So if you don't want to install it on your internal Mac drive, that's fine. Just run from a flash drive or SSD external drive. It doesn't really matter. Linux flies here. The file manager by default is a Dolphin, and I mean, it's cool. I like it. It's just, it works as expected, so no complaints here. The terminal is a console app, standard terminal app, and Office, it has LibreOffice, LibreBase, okay, yeah, all this typical kind of stuff. So, yeah, for me, the Kubuntu is what exactly I need. For you, it might be any different distro you like. There's a bunch of distros you actually can pick from. The main thing is just try it. Just install on your flash drive if you actually want to compare. You can just have a bunch of those flash drives, right, like I have, and actually try those in your machine. It all depends what you actually want. If you want just a graphical thing, if you want simplicity, or if you want to have just the pure Linux experience. Or you can actually configure your Mac to have specific tool sets similar to Linux. And it's actually also one of the ways many people use it. They don't want to use Linux, they just want to keep using Mac, and they just install a bunch of utilities on top of their Mac installation. So why not? And I'm gonna talk actually about that in my next video. So please stay tuned, please subscribe, press the like button, and see you very, very soon. See you later, guys.